This modern era has produced several great women. Media has definitely shone the light on some of them. I'm sure you all recognize these faces. But what about these unsung heroines who have been silently helping to improve the lives of both men and women around the world, sometimes putting their own lives in danger? This documentary is but just a tiny contribution to these silent voices.
The UN reports there are about 1,000 honor murders every year in Pakistan. And these are only the reported cases. A custom that kills did not make any sense to me. And I knew I had to do something about it this time. We started the center, women were coming to make embroidery and going through a life-changing process of education. I truly believe to create women leaders, there's only one thing you have to do. Just let them know that they have what it takes to be a leader.
For the better part of a decade now in northern India, a movement of badass women known as the Gulabi Gang has been building itself a fierce reputation and a membership numbering in the tens of thousands. Recognizable by their matching bright pink saris, these women patrol the countryside of Uttar Pradesh, looking for abusive men and kicking the shit out of them with huge bamboo sticks. In addition to targeting individual rapists and wife beaters, the women of the Gulabi Gang have been known to lay down beatings on misogynistic cops, corrupt politicians, and greedy bosses, all while running massive self-defense trainings and advocating for broader social transformation. While India is by no means a bastion of gender equality, the actions of the Gulabi Gang have resonated strongly with women across the country, and have helped to spark a growing shift in public perceptions around sexual assault and gender dynamics.
It is the people who must save the environment. It's the people who must make their leaders change. So we must stand up for what we believe in.
Over 95% of Afghan women suffer from depression. Every 28 minutes, a woman dies in Afghanistan during childbirth. The life expectancy for Afghan women is only 45 years.
Most of them, because of security, they are wearing burqa. Burqa is not the problem for the women of Afghanistan, and also doesn't solve their problem. Their problem is, first of all, security. Their problem is, first of all, water, food, health, and many more other problems, especially education. Right now, women are in Afghanistan, they do demonstration. Most of them do not have education.
Humans are made from humus. Adam is derived from adamus, the Hebrew word for soil. We are nothing without living soil. And today, we are witnessing that as waves of refugees are created from lands which were desertified, devastated through exploiting of the soil. If we make peace with the soil, we make peace between people. We solve the food insecurity problem. We solve the unemployment problem. We, of course, solve the climate problem.
As we move through the Women's History Month, let's pause to thank the brave women from our history and contemporary society for their contributions.